Hello. Hello. So, this is, what, the third attempt to get this to work? Don't worry about that. I'm just going to be running my screensaver while we're talking, and my screensaver is currently set to just
already
randomly throw up pictures, which I've downloaded. So,
alright, that's two out of three.
Two.
Our pony.
Three out of four.
Our pony. Right already.
And combo breaker of a complete and total black. I don't know what that is. I have another one which is titled 400, which is completely white, which showed up. And I don't know what it is.
Three out of seven.
For the record, Karin somehow managed to grab every single screenshot, every single picture that ever showed up in Riven, and he sent it to me. God only knows why. Okay, so let's try to ignore that and just discuss stuff. It might be kind of difficult. Probably bad showing. Mostly, this is just to sort of have
visuals. But this is
going.
A very, very odd look into Artemis's mind.
This pretty much describes what goes on my mind.
What the heck? I don't even
so
want to know what's been said.
Mostly, that's just gonna be going on while we're talking about whatever we're gonna talk to. So just try to ignore it. And
what the hell is that?
Long story.
Oh my god.
Anyway.
It looks like either it's Mist or it's Pony. Or...
Yes.
What is that?
I don't know. You know what? Fine. I'm just gonna... Okay. I'm not gonna know where this crease
turns off.
Son of a bitch! Okay. So, ignore that. Ignore.
Alright, well, whatever.
So
what do we need to talk about?
Well, let me just quickly... I know that it feels like they already know this, but they don't, because we've already recorded this exact same thing a good 3 times now, and the video keeps corrupting. Time test. Well, not that quick. We're just going to record for like an hour of us just talking, and then we're going to take that hour of footage and post it on YouTube, because YouTube just happily informed me you may now upload for more than 15 minutes, and I'm like... Cool story, bro. How long can I upload for? And it's very helpfully not going to tell me. So
we're just gonna try uploading a video that's as long as possible and seeing if it works.
So
if you're, watching this, then it worked.
Son of a gun! I forgot to check the time before we started. Just a sec.
Yeah, whatever.
We are going at 2 minutes, and we're going at like 3 minutes. So at like 1:50 to 1:47 or so, it will be ready to go. That's right, we were recording this at past midnight. So this is going to be pretty freaking bad.
Alright, and so for the record, you know, this is just for us to see what, you know, what the limit is and so on. So basically we're just going to be talking and whatever, and we don't really expect it to be worth actually listening to all the way through. So don't, frankly...
I'm kind of amazed if you've watched this far into the video. Probably if you are, you're just watching it for my screensaver. So, go ahead, mute your music, begin playing Eurobeat Brony or whatever the crap you want to, and tune us out. I don't care. This is mostly just for us. It's going to take several hours for this to upload to YouTube, because I'm uploading in lossless, uncompressed MOVs. So.
Corey's probably going to have a fit when he hears this.
Oh god, it's not even going to... I checked, I'm pretty sure it's not even going to upload in 420 pixels as well. Which is a really sad thing. I'm pretty sure it's going to do like 360. So, yeah.
Wow.
It's so many levels of pathetic.
But regardless, we've got, you know... Yeah.
I had this mental list of stuff which we could talk about, and it just all went away.
Mm.
On the subject of Corin, He's... Son of a bitch!
He's a guy.
He's a guy. He does this thing.
He's a person.
And if you don't know who Corin is, you obviously don't pay close enough attention to the comic. Neither does he, but he knows who Corin is because... Wait. What the hell? What? I forget. How did we meet Corin?
It was a while back.
Yeah, it was...
I introduced you to him.
Did you? Yeah, you did. That's right.
And
I knew him through...
Oh. Didn't you meet him at a video game club or something?
Yeah, that was it. That was it. Okay.
Or what? No. Or was it... No, I met Calvix at a convention. That's what happened.
Yeah.
I was at a convention and I met Calvix.
But...
I remember when I met him. It is unbelievable that this actually happened, but when I met him, he had a bag of Doritos with him. He is breaking the boundaries for the number of stereotypes he hits. I'm pretty sure stereotypical is a challenge for him. So, anyway.
It is downright surreal to just watch Minecraft Mist Pony. Missed. Pony. Minecraft. Missed. Pony. Missed. Pony. Pony. Missed. Pony. Pony.
Yeah,
pony.
I have a
missed.
Lot of pony.
Knockback. Cool. Pony.
By the way, do you hear that clicking noise? That would be my hippo.
Enderman.
I have a purple stuffed hippo. Richard lost his Installdus, so I started wandering around the house trying to find it, and I found this underneath the couch. So I put it on my head, came back downstairs.
Dummy knife? Really? You're gonna call it a knife? That's fine.
It is.
And
how is that not a knife?
Definitely not. That screenshot would be useless. The code
it's,
there for Riven.
It's not a screen. It's not a screenshot. That's one of the files from the game.
Oh.
You can tell by the weird code on the bottom. As a general rule, I don't code stuff. But I told you not to look at it. Don't make me smack you with my hippo. Oh, that sounds like a euphemism.
Wow.
Come on, baby, let's go upstairs now. Smack you with my hip.
What is that?
I told you not to freaking look at it. Ow! Missed! Yeah, no pun intended. Yeah, okay, man, that was terrible.
Oh,
sorry.
Boy. Simon.
On a They almost have a similar expression, too. Son of a bitch! Pay attention to me, not the screen. It's just quiet. Okay. So.
Lava lamps.
I've always wanted to take a lava lamp and try and heat them over green beans. Like, put it on a plate of green beans and see if it will begin lava lamping. Because
green beans.
Okay, seriously. Have you ever eaten green beans that are fresh out of the pan? They are so freaking hot!
You cook green beans in a pan?
We're talking about the heat of them. We're not talking about my personal cooking methods.
Ardwin Scott cooks green beans in a pan.
Yeah, well, I'm pretty sure that Corin tried to deep fry nachos once, so I don't want to hear it. But to be fair, deep fried nachos would be pretty good.
I'm not even sure.
That
would
sound
really
delicious
good
or nasty.
Right. Oh my goodness.
Also, we're not sure if possible that. Brace yourself for how stupid this person is, but we might be house-sitting in July, so we might have nothing to do but do a full 12-hour live-streaming session. If I can figure out how to set my computer up to do that, in July we might just end up doing a full 12-hour live-streaming session.
We shall see.
I don't know. It's also possible that we'll do it for 2 hours and, like, I'm tired of this. I'm gonna go lock myself in the bathroom with a carrot. And eat the carrot.
What?
And then eat the carrot.
I beg your pardon!
What I want to know, though, is could you drink the exact right amount of liquid to just keep drinking and drinking and drinking until eventually you can just start peeing and just have an infinite loop?
What?
Well, you know...
What?
So you just can keep peeing and drinking at the same time without overloading on either end? It's a valid science fair. Science fair. I have a friend who's in 8th grade. I am going to suggest that to him. Okay, moving on.
Let's move on from that.
Did you know that, for my 8th grade science fair project, I was trying to think of something good to do. So I decided the perfect science fair project would be, what item on the market is the most flammable thing? It was so much fun. Although irritating, I don't actually remember what the result is.
Oh.
Although I do remember for my 7th grade project, cotton was the most flammable cloth.
Good to know.
Yes. If you're going firefighting, don't wear cotton, especially if it's soaked in gasoline. Also, if you soak packing peanuts in gasoline, it makes napalm. I think it's napalm anyway. Thank you, Ross, right, for teaching me that. And also, speaking of Ross Scott, I just realized something. Corin looks like how Ross Scott sounds a little bit.
Hmm.
Like if you were to sort of assign a face to Ross Scott's voice, that looks a little... I feel like Corin looks a bit like that.
Yeah, I can see that. It was a mistake to look at that screensaver.
Yeah, I know. I just need to make sure that
so much what.
I've been downloading images for a long time, and occasionally my hard drive gets deleted, so I just get sent back a little bit. So that means I have to recover everything that I lost. That means I find a bunch of stuff in the meantime, and it devolves into lots of very, very strange things, like John Freeman looking surprised. Corin Miller really likes John Freeman. Not like in a creepy way, but really likes Half-Life Full Life Consequences. I mean, hell, he named his Minecraft account John Froman 42, which is like a cross between John Freeman, Gordon Froman, and the number 42.
Yeah.
Which had... Oh, crap. What does 42 mean? It's...
Well, it's the answer to life, the universe, and everything.
How the fuck did I forget that?
Obviously.
I...
That's, like, really...
Yeah. Basic nerd thing. And sword...
I ran out of clever file names.
You know, it gets really difficult when you're serious. It's really difficult when you're sitting there for hours on end, just sitting in front of this desktop, covered in pictures, trying to come up with creative file names for every single one. Like, it gets really difficult.
You've got an astonishingly disturbing amount of pony on your computer.
Dude, I don't want to hear it. There are people who fill entire external hard drives full of pony images.
Well,
this is pea cake.
Pea
cake.
That's more than a little bit.
Pea cake sounds disgusting, doesn't it? It's a cake made out of peas. Or cake made out of pea. Either way, that's really nasty.
What is it with you and pea? This is actually getting really, really messed up.
The letter P. It starts lots
of
awesome things.
I beg your pardon. Stephen Colbert there.
Son of a bitch! Why is that? Why? I thought it... Some of these are GIFs, so if there's one which makes little sense, like that one, chances are it's a GIF. Don't. Okay, you can there. You know, is this going to be this much of a distraction? Because if so, we're supposed to be talking about interesting things here. It's not a commentary on my psyche. Even though my psyche is pretty messed up.
It's pretty odd. It's getting pretty odd.
And that's not even the weirdest crap that's in there. I don't even know. What is the weirdest thing that I have in there? Meeps! Meeps! 5 second films is best pony.
What?
What? I don't know.
That's...
What?
You wouldn't understand that. Okay.
There's a lot there that I don't understand.
You don't have to understand it. Listen, we gotta go another, like, 30 minutes. Wow. So, this has only just begun, guys.
See, last time, most of the video consisted of us trying to stop the video.
Yes.
Because...
I accidentally crashed the software by blowing up a lot of TNT simultaneously, and then...
He means in Minecraft, not in
yes,
real life.
Yes, I do mean in Minecraft, thankfully. And so then, when that didn't work out very well, it took me, like, literally about 50 minutes of just trying to click on the stop icon. Just sitting there, trying to click on it, until I eventually gave up.
And, we never even actually got it to work. We had to force quit the program, and then, delete the file, because it got dead and was stopping the program from running at all, because it was trying to recover the dead file.
Which is a pity, because actually some of the material we had was pretty good. I mean, compared to a lot of the material we get, which is... Compared to my submachine or deathbed recording, that was bad.
But I'm seriously saying that any of our material is ever any good.
Fair enough. No, yeah, but you gotta... Did I show you the submachine stuff that I took?
I think so.
I was incredibly tired when I took it. I had woken up like 10 minutes ago. And so... so bad.
You need to redo that submachine stuff.
I do. I'm probably going to end up live streaming.
That's a cool
game. I'm probably going to end up live streaming it once I get to live stream. That's another thing. Look forward to an upcoming feature. I am going to be live streaming every so often o'clock at same bat time, same bat channel. And that's right. Just reference Batman. Yep. And
the old Batman.
The really old Batman. And I will be playing Flash games. So
yeah, online Flash games.
Just
maybe I'll do a few, but it's mostly gonna be Art's gig.
And he might do if we can find Achievement Unlock 2 as a multiplayer. I just remembered that. I don't even remember what it is. Because I keep asking you to do it, and you're like, yeah, maybe later. Like, I asked Corin, he's like, I'm too busy playing Left 4 Dead 2. And I'm like, you're always too busy playing Left 4 Dead 2. So I'm not allowed to tell you what Corin's Steam username is. But if you look up longest time played Left 4 Dead people... He's probably one of the people who has over 1,000 hours played. Like, swear to God, 50% of the time when I contact him, playing Left 4 Dead 2. What the fuck? Have you not played through every single campaign? Are you, like, installing mods? You should know there's a mod for Left 4 Dead 2 that makes weapons turn pink and stuff and such and have ponies on them.
Really?
Yes.
Bad effect.
Corky064 showed me the magic of this.
That a fact.
Yes, and you know him.
Oh yeah, that's
Felix
right. Wow. Is he involved in this sickness as well?
It's not a sickness. It's too awesome to be a sickness.
Right.
So is Captain Cool too. Freeman's his mind too.
Well then.
And Ian Reilly is a fan of the show, and I'm pretty sure the person who made Chell's mind, Sai, I think her name is, or Sarah something. She at least owns a rarity doll, I think was mentioned at one point. So.
Oh my god.
I'm not going to comment on that image. I forgot I downloaded that. I just glanced over my screensaver. Anyway. You're sitting on the hippo.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. Psychically, you are. Might not be in physical form, but you are in spiritual form. You know who...
I'm spiritually sitting on... Artemis' stuffed purple hippo.
I bet you are. Abel. It was really weird. I was sitting on my computer talking to Abel at school.
Sitting on your computer?
No, I was sitting while working on my computer at school, and I got up to do something, kid comes over and just types "I love you" into the chat pane of a fucking Google. And I come back and he's like, excuse me, bro. I'm like, well, that was one of the kids at my school. Sure it was. Oh god, no, what have I got myself into? I don't think I've ever gotten friend zoned by another guy though. That's pretty sad.
Oh my god.
I think that's a whole new level of forever alone.
Yeah. Pretty effectively.
I hate the way that sometimes when we're having discussions, we'll just be talking. Everybody's trying to talk over everybody else. And then everybody will run out of things to say and it'll just go dead silent.
I think that's more or less proof that we fail. Like everything that we're trying to do.
Yeah, that's the thing. Because we talk over each other. We're talking, we talk over each other,
all the time. It's like absolutely constant.
And then suddenly, just we both stop talking. And there's just this moment. By the way, Corin keeps bugging me about watching some guy named The Beer Cakes videos. Do you know who he is?
I think I've heard of him. He's done, like, a lot of Amnesia stuff.
Oh, was he the dude who posted that thing on Equestria? Oh, you wouldn't know.
I would not know.
No.
Do I look like CK to you? Do I look like Enrico? Abel? Maybe?
I don't know. What is Kavix's view on the whole thing, though? Do you even know?
I have no idea.
Of course.
Have no idea!
Of course, Corin. He has nothing but contempt for the whole Cody phenomenon. Why do you have a maraca on your bedside table?
I don't even know. There is so much stuff in my room.
Yeah, like this color picture that my computer is sitting on.
There is a story behind that.
Is there?
Yeah, it was... This dates back to, like, a few winters ago.
Really?
When Abel and I were just sort of, like, I forget even what we were doing, but we were driving around for some reason, and this printer was just lying in a snowbank. Like, it was literally just sort of sitting there on the snowbank, and on the side of the road. And so we decided to pick it up. And so someone who left their colored printer in a snowbank is missing their
That is a terrible story. Let me help you change it to make it better. Abel and I were driving around in Czechoslovakia, because everything's more awesome when it's in Czechoslovakia.
Yes, except that Czechoslovakia no longer exists.
Yes, but you are time travelers.
Yes, of course. That makes it better.
I was time traveling, driving around with Abel in Czechoslovakia, when... when as we were fighting some giant orcs, dragons, and
imps,
and
elves,
and Santa,
elves.
Ho ho ho, I will murder your face.
Santa was trying to murder our face when all of a sudden, out of the corner of our collective eye, we saw the
ultimate holy grail of printerdom.
Of all of our travels, we found this printer lying in the snowbank of Galilee.
What I want to know is why was there a printer in a snowbank in Czechoslovakia? Isn't What I want to know, isn't Czechoslovakia, like, really...
No, it isn't! It's in, like, the middle of Europe.
Well, still! Why would they be getting snow there if they almost never get snow in Britain?
Because Britain is, on the west coast of Europe and thus gets all of the, I don't know, trade winds and so on that warm up that side of the ocean even as they cool down the other side. I imagine that Czechoslovakia, being pretty far inland, would be more or less unaffected. Besides, things were colder back then, right? Global warming, people.
Global warming, of course.
That's the answer.
And so then you took the printer back into your time machine and drove into the sunset.
Just when we thought we were safe. All of a sudden, out of nowhere.
The Starship Enterprise!
Yes, it was the Starship Enterprise, and it showed up, and...
Captain Kirk was like, that is not your printer to take, now I must make out with you!
And then Captain Picard showed up, and said,
why are you in the same time frame as me? Because time travel is bullshit!
And then all of a sudden, Janeway came, and she was all over the... And what?
No. And then Sisko showed up and said, Janeway, why did you come? That's weird.
No,
he didn't, because that's weird.
No.
And then Captain Fake showed up and they said, nobody loves you, Captain Fake. Go home to your wheelchair thingy, Robert. And then he left.
And then Archer was like, hey, dude, sup?
And everybody shot him in the face because Archer is terrible.
Oh, my God. And then
the annoying guy from Firefly.
Who was the dude from Firefly? I don't know.
The captain from Firefly showed up and everybody said, wow, you smell like potatoes.
And the dude from Andromeda.
I don't even know. I remember that there's one guy named Tion Andromeda, and I don't even know.
What? Anyway, and then
the guy on... I've never even watched Stargate.
Stargate, yeah, whatever.
Luke Skywalker.
Yes, Luke Skywalker.
Even though it's a terrible movie.
And Obi-Wan Kenobi. And
you was the fuck, Luke!
And then all the robots, and there was a giant battle between Star Trek and Star Wars and Stargate and all of the other little factions of science fiction nerddom.
And then Penny
Abel and I were just sort of saying, okay, guys, we're just going to sort of take this printer and leave.
But before you could, a clone car drove up, and 50 clones got out, and one of them got a banjo, went, 1, 2, 3, and everybody started dancing, and the end. And that's why you have a printer in your room.
Yes. That's the short version.
Now, do you want to do the long version?
How much time do we have left?
We have a 4x5 to go.
So really all we need, but...
Yeah.
I suppose the full hour is what we're going
to
need.
Yeah, the thing is that then we need to do another one, which is a full hour. Holy crap, does that hippo have an anus?
No, don't
look at it.
Don't go there.
It's slightly to the side,
but... don't need to go there at all.
That's fucked up.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to have to go upstairs and get some orange juice or something, because my throat is beginning to hurt.
So if you're watching this, I'm impressed that you've made it this far, and
well,
I guess at this point, you
might
as well. Yeah, if you're skipping through, then, you know,
okay.
See this?
No, you don't, because I don't have my camera on, but if you did, you'd see that I was flipping you off.
At this point, you can basically treat this like a live stream. We're not even doing anything in particular. We're just talking.
Yes. Okay, so here's the long version of the story.
Fair enough.
So Abel showed up at your house.
Yep.
And he's like, okay. Oh, no, I need my Abel voice. Okay, Richard. We need to go down to the store and get some seltzer. And you're like, well, okay, Abel. No, I got this backwards. Okay, Abel. Okay, Abel, let's go down to the store and get some milk. And so they went down to the store, and then I showed up and said, no, you don't need to go to the store to get milk. I have some milk in my TF2. And they're like, no, we must go to Czechoslovakia.
And then the doctor showed up, and he said,
you can't go to Czechoslovakia. It doesn't exist.
And TMBG started making up a song on the spot based on their Istanbul, not Constantinople song. It's no longer Czechoslovakia. It's now the Czech Republic and Slovakia. And so
they said, well, that's not a problem, Doctor. Get out of the way. We need to use our TARDIS. And so you got into the TARDIS, and you pressed, and Roman came in and pressed buttons, and blah, 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 tiny, whiny stuff, and bam, you're in Czechoslovakia.
Czechoslovakia, in all its glory. And
onto the wonderful wintry land of Czechoslovakia.
And
Bear walked up you and said, hello. are you looking for a magical white and color printer? And you said,
yes. No, we just want milk.
Well, I have a very nice printer, and it can print out pictures of milk.
And we said, no, we want actual milk.
Well, fine. It can print out hyper-realistic 1080 pixels versions of milk.
And we said, okay, we'll take that. So then the bear led us across many a snowy landscape, mile after mile. We wondered, why the hell didn't we just take the TARDIS? And the doctor said, timey-wimey stuff. And that was good enough for us for some reason.
And then K-9 showed up for some reason, even though he's still in an alternate dimension. I don't know how that works. And then he drove away going, meep, 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 beep, boop, son, beep, boop.
How many things have we referenced so far?
I don't even know.
So then, all of a sudden, we reached this one holy snowbank, which had this color printer sitting on top of it. A glow with all kinds of sunbeams everywhere, and, you know, the god's lights, and then, there's, like, mist and glowy effects, and, you know, you have all of the classic, like,
yes,
beautiful.
So, and then the bear!
Soft focus and ocean ripple and everything.
And then the bear said, you shouldn't have come here. And he began to get hunched over and started twisting and turning and contorting horribly.
And I said, oh no! It's the end boss! And so we had to go fighting the final boss and actually...
And then he turned into Dr. Breen and said, ha, you will not escape! And slapped Richard in the face. And Amy went, no, you don't!
and ran faster!
And so then, just when it was about to be over for Richard, the doctor said, I will save you, and use a sonic screwdriver! And the bear destroyed the doctor. Only the bear wasn't the bear anymore, he was Dr. Breen. I kind of forgot that!
The bear Breen attacked Doctor who was actually David Tennant, but simultaneously Tom Baker, because Tom Baker was pretty much just as awesome as David Tennant, and also Matt Smith, because
he has one-third scarf, one-third timey-wimey stuff, and one-third a fez.
A fez?
Yes.
Okay.
Doesn't Matt Smith wear a fez?
I don't even remember. I've only seen a couple of episodes of Matt Smith.
I don't know. I don't remember
him wearing his fez at all.
I don't... Okay, tell us in the comments.
Anyway,
Matt Smith, wear a fez.
He managed to actually get through this far somehow. Anyway, so, we're, you know, fighting the final boss in a John Freeman-esque battle, which is actually kind of pathetic because we're so unoriginal, we're just stealing ideas from everything at this point.
And then, suddenly, just when the world was beginning to get dark, a man showed up on his bicycle. It was the one, the only, Gordon Freeman!
And
you don't know who Gordon Freeman is, so I'll take it from here.
Go for it.
He bankled forward on his bicycle. and he parked next to it and said, something! I don't remember Gordon Freeman either! It's too late at night for me to make sense.
So then
Gordon Freeman decided that he didn't remember who he was, and so he turned into Gordon Freeman and didn't say anything for the rest of time.
And then, just when we thought nothing more was going to happen, something happened.
Cheryl showed up, got a portal gun, and hit people in the face with a crowbar, because she's actually Gordon Freeman. Didn't you see her goatee? Now we have two Gordon Freeman!
And then all of a sudden, someone else... Let's see, who else can we show up?
Okay, here's what. Then suddenly we heard a deep voice begin complaining in our ears about bad gameplay decisions, and somebody with a cool hat came running on. None other than... Come on, really? Yahtzee Croshaw!
Oh, okay, cool.
Come on!
Oh my god. You should have said, like, you know, black cardboard cutout shapes. Okay,
and a stupid empty little thingy with bummer.
Yes!
So and that's where the imps come from in the short version of the story. Did you forget that? I hope you didn't forget.
And then all of a sudden, but we still have to explain away the orcs and stuff. So all of a sudden,
yes. So suddenly, Corin stopped the entire universe and quickly installed more animals. And then installed single player commands typed in
on the world
spawn orc.
And then so suddenly, and it was good, and there were 20 orcs, like, right in front of us,
and they began smashing the ground, and we're like, oh my holy fuck, oh my holy fuck, we're fucking the foley!
Thank you, pardon. So Abel and I are pretty much confused right now, given that a lot of stuff was happening. And so, you know, we were looking at each other, and so we just sort of, you know, that's not really anything stop us from just sort of grabbing that printer over there.
Oh, sorry, the printer! Stop my screensaver!
Oh, dear. Okay, so...
Alright, I'll stop... Oh. Okay, let's go.
So we have the printer now. And I put it in my inventory, of course, so
yes.
we didn't have
yes.
to deal with, like, lugging that giant printer around.
Yes,
and
then you got out your lantern and that's, oh my god, I'm almost out of oil. And so you realize you had to run like Vegas, and then Abel said, wait, I have some oil, I'm passing you on.
I didn't bother to ask where he'd gotten that oil from, but... I hope it wasn't his butt.
Oh my god! There goes all that 70! And then suddenly Obama came over and shot lasers! And then we noticed something. He had a cat on his shoulders.
And then he threw that cat at us and it started ripping and clawing in our faces.
And then, where did this robot come from? There wasn't a robot here before.
And so, I want Fluffy. And then we're like, oh god, we've devolved into referencing Flash games now.
And then we heard a noise.
A noise like no other that we'd heard before.
It sounded a little bit like this.
Oh fuck, are you serious?
And then suddenly the world got beaten. And when we respawned, we found ourselves in Czechoslovakia, but everything was gone!
But the printer was right there, so we picked it up again. And
then Colin
set off again on our mighty quest to get back to the...
And then suddenly, for no reason, because we need to keep... everything in order. A bunch of animals ran out of nowhere. All of the animals that we mentioned, including Santa, who still wanted to kill our face.
And so... And everyone from TF2 showed up, too, for good measure.
Yeah!
So we've got Heavy, and we've got Pilot, we've got Spy, and we've got...
Scout!
Engineer, Scout!
Son of a bitch! Medic!
Medic! And, I can't think of all
Sniper!
Names. Sniper! And we've got...
Spy!
Spy! No, I already spent Spy!
You didn't spy!
I said...
You spied Spy! Yes, you didn't spend
Spy! I spent Spy!
I spy!
I'm Heavy. I don't think I said Heavy yet, somehow. And
yes, you did! You
said
it twice!
Okay, damn it! So, I need to start over again. Why am I having such difficulty with this?
Heavy! I don't know!
Pyro, those are the main melee classes! Then you've got the
Diamonds melee classes!
Well, I don't care.
Especially not Pyro! I never use.
You've got offense, defense, and support! Okay, so we've got offense, who is Heavy, Pyro, and Scout. Okay, defense, you've got Engineer and. Sniper, maybe?
No, he's
no,
support.
Is he support?
Heavy is defense, too.
Is he really?
Yes.
Are you serious? No, he's offense.
Yeah, no, he's not.
You're joking.
I'm not.
Okay, yeah, you're definitely wrong.
I'm not.
I played a lot more TF2.
You are not. I am not.
Okay, this is getting absurd.
Okay. Motherfucker, so all the TF2 people
they're trying to steal the printer because it's blue.
Yeah.
And they're all red. And they think it's a briefcase. And
we have to get the printer! And then suddenly, a guy in a tuxedo shows up and said, this is all a dream. Now you have to wake up.
Fuck Leonardo DiCaprio now!
Are
you kidding?
No, Leonardo DiCaprio, this isn't a dream. Then we kept him in the head, just as his name suggested.
What? No, it's DiCaprio.
We took the cap out of his head. I put it on the water bottle.
We decapped him by shooting the hat off of his head. We shot his cap off.
But he's wearing a tuxedo. He's wearing a tuxedo and a baseball cap.
Yes.
And then the other shows up. I don't know why. That was his baseball cap. And he said, come on, guys. Why is there a bullet hole in my baseball cap? That was a terrible accent.
Actually, it was decent. So then, Rachel shows up.
Who the fuck is Rachel?
Like, man, the girl from TF2, L4D2.
Michelle, not Rachel.
Michelle, cool. And you've got, you know, then Coach.
And Coach hoped that there was a chocolate helicopter. But then a chocolate helicopter showed up, and everybody got on it, flew away. Then you...
Everyone! It was very crowded.
It was a very large chocolate helicopter.
Andrew and I were not particularly happy with the situation, but he seemed to be enjoying himself a surprising amount, even though I was quite uncomfortable.
That was because he decided to take off his pants.
Why did that split second? Heavy took off his pants, and then... Everything went downhill from there.
Then you both fell out of the helicopter.
And thankfully, we landed
you didn't land in 3 blocks of water. You landed in a small computer processor and fell in through the faxing drive and found yourself in the internet.
Oh, fuck. This is gonna go badly.
Yes. And the first thing you see was porn, because that's the majority of the internet. And then creepy old men.
Okay.
And then you saw ponies.
Yeah, probably quite a decent number of them.
Yes. And so then Corn hacked you out of that, and you took the printer, and you started to go home. But of course it doesn't even matter. Oh, no. Because the Enterprise showed up. Because time shit is bull. Or something like that. Time shit is what a clock poops. Clock poop. It's time shit.
Clock poop. So then we've got...
Guys, if you're still watching this, I can't decide if I admire you or pity you.
So, we've got... So, with all the time shit and clock poop going on... clock
poop. Yes.
We have everyone from Star Trek, all of the different...
All the sci-fi, and then a giant marshmallow shows up with a bite taken out of it.
Beg pardon?
I forget his name! But he's on the man with my poster behind you!
You mean Marshy from
Marshy!
Oh my god!
Marshy! Leave the kid down my street that's named Marshy!
Okay, so then
and then a third grader shows up and he says hi, and then he walks away with his lollipop, licking it quietly, going, lollipop.
In a totally platonic way.
Yes. And then we go to Pluto. Because you said plutonic, and that made me think of Pluto.
I actually totally misused that word, because...
I thought you did!
Plutonic refers to relationships and not actions, really, I think. So,
anyway, we need to stop fighting. So everybody got off of every single ship.
Why can't we be friends?
And so they all got off of all of their Enterprises and Fireflies and Serenias and all that other crap. And then they all... And then, except for Captain Pike, because nobody likes Captain Pike. And Chekhov can stay home and do the dishes. And then they all got...
Terrible hair.
And then they all got into the good...
This Russian accent.
And then they all got into the Goodyear blimp.
And yes! Goodyear blimp!
And they quietly took off and went into space. And they went to Pluto. And then they all had a very nice picnic.
And then Lightlabel and I were walking along peacefully through a meadow. And
we don't ask me why we went from a winter wonderland to a meadow! Totally Santa!
We're halfway across the road because Santa took his...
He got sick of trying to want to kill our face, and he ate his way out of the chocolate helicopter and brought us magically to some sort of happy meadow. And then Betty showed up, and they said, "Hi, Betty!" And you were like, "Oh my god, these buddies can talk!" And then they said, "That's because we're the killer buddies of death." "Oh no! I thought there was only one of us! Get the holy hand grenade!"
Awesome! So, we got the holy hand grenade, and we counted not from 5, not from 2, but from 3! And then
the GM showed up and said, "No, you must get the liver so I can make you a delicious stew."
Wow. Okay, so there's touching the references now! And so we got the Bunny Livers, and then, after that,
we punch Santa in the face! Because
Santa
don't like Santa!
No, we don't like Santa! So apparently we don't like Santa now!
No!
And apparently we're probably gonna be getting cold this winter! And
then God showed up and said, ho ho ho, I'm secretly Santa Claus!
So we punched God in the face now?
Yes, we
awesome.
Just punched God in the face!
Awesome!
And it's like, no, you are no naughty boys, you are not getting any salvation this Christmas!
Holy crap!
And so they sent us to Hades, and we fell off of Mount Olympus and fell to Hades. We fell so fast that we passed a bunch of people on our way. And then we saw a bunch of cats dancing, because why not? I wanted to mention Cryak.
That's
or Cryak, whatever the
fuck
you pronounce it.
Yeah, whatever. Cows and he's got some cool stuff. Anyway, so then we were falling past cows now.
And we also fell so fast that we fell past Kronos, or whatever his name was.
Since when are you involved in this? This was just Abel and me.
I know, I'm saying we, because I'm secretly Abel.
Okay, cool! So
yes, that's why my penis is so big.
So, okay then.
And then we got stuck in darkened corridors. And we're like, oh no, darkened corridors. And I hope you still have that lantern and the butt oil, because you're stuck in darkened corridors. Luckily you found Stefano! Do you know who Stefano is, Richard?
I do not!
Stefano is a guy holding a sword! And he has a French accent! And his name is Stefano!
Do you know this?
Because I'm bored and I looked up videos on YouTube!
Really?
Yes! I watched a video of a mannequin stabbing a guy in the chest!
That seems really unpleasant!
It was really unpleasant!
Okay! So
yes! So we saw Pluto. No, we never went to Pluto.
Everyone else went to Pluto, but
we never went to Pluto.
We're on a grassy metal, but now we're falling down past Kronos into Hades.
Once we were in Hades and we got past the darkened corridors with the grunts and the Justine monsters and crap, suddenly this guy looked at you and he's like, "Hi, my name is Hades." And Abel's like, "Wow, you're a spicy beast." And he said, "Oh, wow, do you really think so?" And he stroked his lovely brown hair and touched his lovely, firm buttocks. And
what?
And then said, "Well, if you think that's true." And Abel said, "Oh, yes, I do." Then he said, "Oh, I'm French now!"
And everybody's like, "Oh, no!
French people!
The afterlife is France! Oh, God, we've gone to film cow!
Charlie! We gotta be sneaky!"
And so...
And then a guy... And then, "Don't worry, I'll get us out of here." Sir Swoopy shows up!
No, that's the wrong song. Now we're in the Forgotten
Realms! Okay,
and then
Guillermo's Manuel, or whatever his name is, said, "No!" And then they left. And then the French Satan guy with very firm buttocks said, "Oh, ha ha, a croissant!"
And gave us a croissant.
No, I put that in my
hand. Oh, thank you, croissant! We took our croissant and we took our printer and we left Hades because that's Paris now.
Yes!
And
yes! And on the
And what happened there?
Then we fell in the pits of Tartarus because Abel tripped.
And we
got a lot of hell out of it.
Yes, we got lots of tartar sauce.
Hello, tartar fishes.
And then we left Tartarus because it sucked and there weren't any gift shops.
Yes.
And
it smelled slightly like French people.
Still?
Yes, because this is still technically Hades, even if it was Tartarus. Tartar sauce. It's tartar sauce! And then we took a tartar bath in tartar sauce, and very sticky!
And we flew out on a gigantic eagle, which we found after we were, you know, messing about in Film Cow Land.
Yes!
Which apparently is in Hades!
Right, I got some flies! By the way, my eggs got burnt! And that's how they got teleported to another dimension. Son of a bitch!
What time is it?
I don't know! Oh, it's only 1:37. We are so fucked! We gotta keep this going for another 10 minutes, Richard!
Alright, so, we got back out of Hades!
We got out of Hades with Tartarus and Tartar Sauce and gift shops and all sorts of magical things! And then Abel said quiet, he just leaned over to your ear and said, "There's something I gotta tell you."
What did they expect?
Dude, then Heavy Red's guy came over and killed the surprise butt sex spy or whatever. Oh, nuts! You just have to make a computer, you son of a bitch! And then Artemis' computer got unplugged and he panicked like an asshole. And then George Carlin showed up and complained at us for a while.
In the air, because we're still on the gigantic eagle. I
yes!
Know where he is, but he started flying by.
He was having a blip. It came back from Pluto with George Carlin. Because George Carlin has a Pluto!
And so, Heavy flies by on a giant sandwich saying, "No! Nom, obscure YouTube video.
Yay!
And then we got
obscure videos. I don't even know that one.
And we've got the, the engineer started building a century repeatedly to the tune of Riverside by Sidney Samson.
And then, and we got new weapon.
Cool!
And also, spy, spy to spy. Do, 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 do. Okay, and I just ran out of ideas.
Yeah,
I'm sweating. I've been talking so much, I'm actually breaking into sweat.
This is actually way more intense than it should be.
It is. And then, out of nowhere, explosive bacon. and then the bacon exploded. We got flown all over.
Loaded again.
And we got exploded all the way back to Czechoslovakia. And the doctor said, "Sup, fool, I've been waiting for you." And then we went back to our real time because we're only like 7 minutes away from finishing this.
Alright, cool. So we're back in our own time now.
But that's not it. Because then Artemis walked up and said, "Nice printer! You forgot the milk, didn't you?" Kami went over and said, "All right, we need to go back to Czechoslovakia. Czechoslovakia. It's late on the night that I can't pronounce Czechoslovakia. Son of a bitch! Your laptop screensaver just activated."
That is actually one of the nerdier screensavers I've ever seen that I quite like it mimics a TNG monitor and like pretends that it's like my computer is scanning the universe and stuff. It's amusing. We're back in Czechoslovakia for no particular reason.
No, we need milk! We have a very good reason. We need milk!
So the scout shows up.
The scout
from Pluto and mad because
he doesn't have any milk either! And so they all went happily and arguing, "We must get milk, we must get milk!"
Then all of a sudden the scout dies for no particular reason, then when he
respawns,
he has found milk! He has found the mad milk!
Well, no, that's a very good reason! He was really Artemis and he lagged out because the server was buggy!
Oh, okay, that works then. So after he dies, he finds the mad milk. And he's willing to trade with us, which is great because we need milk.
And so we give him the butter and the lantern. And for some reason, out of his butter and his lantern, as well as this croissant from Satan.
Oh, it's a Satan croissant.
And then they took him that milk and said, milk. And went back home out and said, "Awesome milk." And he drank it and went insane. And that's why I'm insane. The end!
Okay, cool.
Yeah, son of a bitch, my throat hurts!
Okay, you know, that was fun.
How long has this been going for? I think this might be long enough. It's been going for 54 minutes. Do you want to just say that's good? Because that was...
Yeah, sure, why not?
Alright, guys. So this has been Artemis and Richard discussing Czechoslovakia and getting milk. And
all kinds of other inexplicable
things
because...
George Carlin, the Goodyear blimp, Pluto, and lots of TF2 references. Good night!